One more company from the Bajaj Group called Bajaj Housing Finance Limited is coming up with an IPO. The IPO size is a whooping 7,000 crores. So now generally when a company comes for an IPO, they have a motive behind its IPO. But you will be surprised to know that this IPO by Bajaj Housing Finance Limited is a compulsion and not motive based. Why a compulsion? So this is backed by RBI's guideline. According to RBI's guideline, upper layer NBFCs are required to get their shares listed max by September 2025. So Bajaj Housing Finance Limited, being an upper layer NBFC, is mandatorily required to get their shares listed on the stock exchange. Though this decision of an IPO is a compulsion decision, the company is still going to receive 7,000 crores. So what are they planning to do? Is this company fundamentally strong? As retail investors, should we invest in this company? So the answer to all these questions is in the video ahead. So do watch the entire video. As the name suggests, Bajaj Housing Finance Limited is a lending company. They finance loan to individuals and corporate entity for the purchase of home or corporate offices. They also provide for the renovation of home or corporate offices. They are into lease discounting, developer finance, and not only this, they also provide loan against property to individuals and corporate entities either for personal or business use. Now, recently they have added one more new stream of income. In December 2023, the company has tied up with IREDA to mark themselves as a corporate distributor of insurance, life, marine, business, health, etc. So this is going to generate more revenue to the company. As on 31st March 2024, the company's asset under management stood at 9,13,704 million. Out of this huge chunk, 58% were home loans, and even in this 58%, 85% of the home loans were through salaried employees. Why is this important? Because salaried employees rank better. They remain intact even in the economic downturns caused due to COVID, inflation, geopolitical situation, etc. The average ticket size of a home loan is 46 lakh rupees. The quality of the loan given by the company can be determined and studied based on few parameters. One such parameter is loan to value ratio. The loan to value ratio of Bajaj Housing is 70.5%. Now, what is loan to value ratio? If I go to a banker with one property worth 10 lakh rupees and I tell the banker that I need a loan against this property, what is the maximum amount that the bank is going to sanction? Of course, not the entire 10 lakh rupees. They have to keep a margin. So this is the margin. How much margin a bank has is a loan to value ratio. In the given example, the maximum amount of loan that I can get is 10 lakh into 70.5%, which is 7,05,000 rupees. The second parameter is every bank determines a CIBIL score of the applicant. Now, in the case of Bajaj Housing Finance, almost 76% of the loans are given to people with CIBIL score more than 750, which is a very good point. The company's CAGR has increased by 30.9% between the years 2022 to 2024. Their revenue have also increased from 37,167 million in the year 2022 to 76,177 million in the year 2024. The company's gross NPA as on 31st March 2024 stands at 0.27% and the net NPA is only 0.1%. NPA is nothing but the defaulting loan. Out of all the loans given by the bank or NBFC, what is a defaulting loan portion? The company is in the business of lending. So it is very obvious that they borrow money from various sources and then they lend it to general public at large. So the cost of their borrowing varies from 6% to 7.6%, whereas the interest income or the interest rates that they charge for the loans they provide vary from 8.5% to 10.2%. The company has been very consistently maintaining a spread between 2.5% to 3%. percentage. What we have discussed till now is the past performance and the past financial figures of the company. What about the future? Whether the company's business is going to grow even in the future is a big question mark. In India, even today, major portion of anybody's saving is held in the form of real estate. Any average Indian's holding in real estate is almost 77% of his or her entire saving. Now, despite this huge population interested in real estate, only 12% of India's population is getting loan from financial institution, and the remaining chunk is still using informal sources like friends, relative, etc. to get funds to invest or to purchase a house property. Now, government has come up with many initiatives to bridge this gap, which is a clear signal that there is going to be a demand of home loans in the future. Further, rise in the hybrid working model have also increased the demand of housing properties in our country. Now, talking about the risk associated with the business, the first and the foremost risk is the cost of borrowing. Interest rates are continuously regularized by RBI, so any decision taken by RBI there is going to impact the performance of the company. Also, the company has to continuously enter into competitive agreements, find competitive investors who are ready to give them funds at a very competitive rate so that their margin remains intact. The second risk is the real estate sector is not having a constant demand for its product. This is because of any warlike situation or geopolitical situation, economic downturns or pandemic like COVID can impact the demand segment of real estate. The third point is that almost 85% of the company's revenue comes from 5 states, that is Maharashtra, Gujarat, Karnataka, Telangana and New Delhi. So any economic tension or policy change in this state is going to impact the financials of the company. That is all about the fundamentals of Bajaj Housing Finance Limited. The company is coming up with an IPO worth 7,000 crores, and out of this 7,000 crores, 4,000 crores is for fresh issue of shares and the remaining 3,000 is for offer for sale. Now, who are selling the shares? The company has only one shareholder. Yes, it is a wholly owned subsidiary of Bajaj Finance Limited. So, Bajaj Finance Limited is going to sell their shares in return of a whopping 3,000 crores. So, that is all about the IPO. I hope you have benefited from this IPO and you make an informed decision before investing in any IPO. I will see you in the next video. Until then, bye.
Investments in securities markets are subject to market risks. Read all the related documents carefully before investing.